And so it is that people have shown their best side, best face, best intentions, best movement to obtain, after 7,000 years, the map of freedom. You gotta hand it to the people of Egypt, the most ancient of civilizations are known to man, have come up with the number one all-time revolution in the attempt to secure themselves their rightful birthright to live in apparent freedom with the apparent natural born constituents of honor and citizenship and freedom and the ability to say and do what is appropriate in their mind and heart. There is nothing more that one can gain by the experience of living than to manifest yourself under the assumption that you amount to more than an ant on a piece of feces using your animation, your life source, to bring the piece of feces back to the queen. So she can eat it and lord it over a little tiny ant. And whatever comes from all this, inside from my latest song, I don't know. But certainly the intentions and the way this was carried about, and it shows that, you know, that this is an ancient and proud and intelligent people of the highest order, and probably from outer space is where they came from. Certainly, it's a far cry from the pyramids, you know, to someone shuffling through the savannah and dodging cheetahs and jumping into trees so the hares and lions don't devour them. You know, while they're running around half naked, trying to, you know, put some shrubs and half poison artifacts of the ground into some water and heat it up and make some kind of gruel. It's certainly a far cry from that to King Tut's tomb. So one has to be a bit wary of where this all came from. It must be that all men are descended from the Egyptians, the first, at least men of freedom. You know? think that the Egyptians were the only ones that were not originally orangutans and apes, monkeys and baboons and gorillas, and, marmots, varmints, chipmunks, lemurs, and cats and dogs and fleas. Egyptians have come from a higher order from outer space, probably. And we are the children of the Egyptians, and we ought to walk like Egyptians. Honor these people who took to the streets. And as far as I know, overthrew one of the an entire 7,000-year culture of obedience, bondage, slavery, misery, poverty, silencing, murder, torture, misbehavior, thievery on the highest scale. I mean, after all, the boss man seems to have taken every dollar the United States sent him in the last 30 years, which is about $70 billion, and stuck it right in his account there in Zurich. So he's made out like a bandit, but you know, once you attach yourself to a feeding tube like that, it's very hard to get disattached. What the quarter his head hanging from a lamppost in the main street of Cairo, a stop sign in between red and green lights, enabled him to find the requisite moxie to step down with his henchmen, you know, and book flight to France or something, where all despots wind up in the air, because the French tolerate anything, because they are the coolest of people. Anyway, who knows where it'll wind up. Maybe it might wind up with Malibu. Anyway, the Egyptian people got their work cut out for them now, but they've appointed themselves in the highest way, and they can only commiserate. The allies, at least in spirit, because all the things that we all aspired to took evolution and shape in the youngsters and whoever else was out there in the streets and in the square for 18 days, and determination and being in the right makes for unassailable might. And no one can stop that kind of vibe and feeling or deeds. And so I have to say that this February 11th and 12th and 10th period will probably be the highlight of all of all those who are breathing at the moment and understand what's going on somewhat. And there probably won't be any more momentous, you know, event like this in our lifetime, unless, you know, that mysterious planet comes and crashes into the Earth in 2012. And causes the poor Egyptians to have more bad luck. You know, if Taste of Freedom only lasts about 18 months. hope that the no mystery planet, the world we're in 2012, the Egyptians will get to enjoy, you know, disco dancing, voting, and drinking Diet Sprite, and eating McDonald's, and going to movies, and, you know, fornicating, you know, like minxes, which is what we stand for in the West. Three cheers for the people of the ancient land of Egypt. Long may you prosper. Peace out. Peace three. Freedom. Right on. Power to the people.